С одной стороны можно видеть Джагай Матхай,
where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu he forgave the offenses of Devananda Pandit, where he forgave the offenses of Jagannath Madai.
Это то самое место, где Чайтанья Махапрабху просил Девананда Пандита оскорбления и Джагай Мадая,
и Гопал Пандит.
Чампак.
Гопал Чампак. Это место, на котором прощаются все оскорбления. Это то самое место, где Джагай Мадай были прощены.
Bhakti is extremely pragalba, it's very aggressive.
Bhakti is очень агрессивно, прагалба.
And therefore nothing can stop the progress of bhakti.
Поэтому ничто не может остановить прогресс бхакти.
Even sins cannot stop the progress of
bhakti. Даже грехи не могут остановить прогресс бхакти.
Because it's прагалба, very aggressive.
Bhakti прагалба. Очень решительная и смелая.
This is why Krishna said api chat sutracho bhakte mam ananyava.
Поэтому Кришна говорит Бхагавад-гите,
However, aparad takes part.
Он все равно мой
offense.
Но аппаратки могут остановить прогресс партии.
And the effect of offenses may last for many lifetimes.
И последствия оскорблений могут длиться в течение долгих жизней.
So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has manifested this place in Navadvip Dham, the aparad bhanjan part.
Поэтому Махапрабху милостиво проявил это место аппарат.
Where the reactions of offenses in this life and previous lives all are washed away and forgiven by the mercy of Gauranitaya.
Там вкрытие, где по милости Гауранитая все аппаратки из прошлых жизней и этой жизни могут быть смыты полностью.
So Srila Prabhupada established his life here, because staying here and doing bhajan here is very effective and beneficial.
И Парам Гурудев поэтому основал свой марг именно тут, потому что тут очень благоприятно находиться и совершать марг.
This gate is called Narahari Tara. Narahari was a disciple of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur gave him the title of Seva Vigraha, the embodiment of service.
Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur дал имя Seva Vigraha, просто олицетворение служения.
So Param Gurudev made this gate. It means that if you want to enter into have darshan of Radha Krishna, then you have to go through the gate of following in the footsteps of Narahari. Become Seva Vigraha, the embodiment of service to Guru and Vaishnava.
In честь его, Param Gurudev открыл эти ворота, чтобы сказать, что попасть в краткие песни, нужно пройти через ворота
Севы. He designed this mat with many astonishing features. For example, he designed this, the temple here, it has 9 spires. Representing the 9 angas of bhakti. On the 4 corners you can see there are 4 vigrahas of the 4 sampradaya acharyas. Below there is the first vigraha of C.C. Radha Vinod Bihari. This is very important. Because Sri Krishna has a fair complexion. This is actually the Rasaraj Mahabhav Swarup that Vai Ramananda saw. It is not some speculation of the Gauranga Nagaris. It's not some speculation of Gauranga
Nagaris.
Because Sri Ramananda Rai, describing this form, he said, I see you and your dark complexion is covered by the golden complexion of Radhika.
Потому что Рай Рамананда говорит, я вижу тебя, и твоя темная кожа начинает освещаться и покрываться светлой кожей, сиянием через тело Радхи.
Then you are holding a fruit in your lips. So the Rasaraj Mahabhav Swarup is a swarup of Krishna in Krishna Lila, where Krishna becomes completely bathed in the complexion of Radhika.
Rasaraj Mahabhav Swarup is a swarup of Krishna, именно в Krishna Lila, в которой Krishna полностью освещен золотистым сиянием, исходящим из тела Шримати Радхики.
So here, there is a, over this side, there is a toilet section. And that is called Gyana Kanda.
Этот угол называется Гьяна Канда.
Because Param Gurudev said, what is better, to taste sugar or become sugar? So if you become sugar, then you cannot taste anything. So the Brahman realization, what is the difference if you become stool? Stool can also not smell itself. So this path of Gyan should be completely rejected. So the toilet section of the mud is called the Gyana Kanda. So on the first day of Kartik, in 1968, Param Gurudev came here for the Sanja Aarti and was dancing and went into the Mahasamadhi.
In 1969,
Param Gurudev came here for the Sanja Aarti and Mahasamadhi. And Gurudev, Srila Baba Maharaj, and
Srila Baba Maharaj, and Srila Baba Maharaj, and Srila Baba Maharaj,
and Srila Baba Maharaj,
and Srila Baba Maharaj, and Param Gurudev left, his prominent disciples, Srila Vamraj, Srila Jivraj, Srila Narayan Raj, they did not quarrel who will be Acharya. They made a vote and they voted for each other. In the end, they took advice of Sri Rup Siddhanti Maharaj, a disciple of Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur, and he came and helped them manage all legal affairs after the disappearance of their
Gurudev.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Vaman Maharaj, he was the senior host. So in order to solve their internal management situation, they went to most senior Vaishnava they could find from outside to come, who was impartial and give direction. And it was decided that Srila Vaman Maharaj would become Acharya because he was senior host. He was donated, his mother donated him to the court to Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur when he was 9 years old. So he received Haridan from Prabhupada Srila Bhaktisiddhanta
Sarasvati
Thakur. So
Srila Valmaraj became Acharya, but he took this post in the spirit, I am doing this as a service for my God brothers. They asked me to do it as a service to them and to my brothers. I have never seen a Vaishnava so bhajan parayan as Srila Vaman Maharaj.
Was in his room.
Day and night, he's just like his murti here, as his murti is sitting here like this, and chanting, just like this. He only took off his mala to say Stavan Stuti. Namaste Kav Chaitanya Sridharam. And then do Gayatri. And then again Astakam. And then again
Mahamantra.
Like this, day and night. So completely absorbed. Actually, he spoke perfect English. Better than Gurudev. But he very rarely spoke. And when it, every year thousands of people would come to take Harinam and Diksha from him. And he would give the Harinam and Diksha mainly in large groups on Gurpaninda. So before giving initiation, he would go and he would fall at the feet of his younger godbrothers, like Gurudev and Srila Charika Maharaj. And he would take their permission to give initiation. And he would beg, please forgive me for this sinful act.
Он просил у них разрешения инициировать, и я прошу прощения за этот грех.
thinking, I am not qualified. And you, and my God, you are more qualified. So please forgive me for this simple act of giving initiation. Not like now in the modern days, everyone trying to initiate everyone else before someone else can initiate them. So here show the ideal example of Vaishnava behavior in his prachar and in his bhajan also. So Srila Trivikram Maharaj and Gurudev and Srila Vamraj all received sannyas on the same day. They were very, very close. So Srila Trivikram Maharaj left this world first. And then 2 years later, Srila Vamraj disappeared on the same day. And then about 5 years later, my Gurudev disappeared on the appearance day of Srila Vamraj. So they all appeared and disappeared on each other's days. This is how close these God brothers were. So I think they are like Naratam, Srinivas and Shamananda. The eternal associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they have set the example of how to cooperate perfectly with proper Vaishnava etiquette and affection for each other. So we have come here to honor, give respect to them of the
street.
And have darshan of the Rasaraj Mahabhav, C.C. Radha Vinod Bihari. And pray for the mercy of C.C. Gornitai in this place. With whatever offenses you may have committed in this life and in previous lives, please mercifully remove these obstacles from the path of our bhakti so that we can begin to make some progress in bhajan. Sri Devananda Gaudiya Bhakti. So now take our return and we'll go to Keshe. That's what Prime said.